Günaydın hocam.
Haydi istediniz. Let's continue with heat transfer from external surface. Okay, as you remember from heat transfer lecture from license education. Consider a fin, as you see from figure, and environment at T infinity. If we take a cross section from fin, as you see, we consider heat is conducted through the SQX, okay, and also lateral surface, as you see, convection surface area. Let me show. Okay, and also from this surface, heat is transferred by convection. Okay. And also this area is cross section area, and then this fin slice which is dx, okay, in x direction, and then it is transferred from cross section area as qx plus dx. As you remember, okay. So if we write heat balance equation, Qx is equal to letter case Qx is equal to letter case Qx plus dx plus dq convection. So let's assume that this equation is star equation. As you remember, Fourier's law of conduction, heat transfer rate Qx is equal to minus K cross section area dT dx. And also we can write again heat transfer rate from the cross section area, as you see from the right hand side, Qx plus dx is equal to Qx plus dqx dx dx. So if we rewrite star equation by substituting qx and qx dx, so we can write qx, or we can write input rate should be equal to output rate, okay. Qx should be equal to Qx plus dQx dx dx plus H dAs times T minus T infinity. Okay, so this is energy balance equation, as you know. So after simplification and cancellation, left hand side gives 0 is equal to d dx minus k cross section area dt dx dx plus h das times t minus t infinity. Okay, so if we assume that conductivity is constant, then we can write out of the differentiation operation, then d dx cross section area dt dx minus h upon k das dx times t minus t infinity is equal to 0. And then if we taking derivatives, we can write the same equation as d square t dx square plus 1 upon ac times dac dx times dt dx minus 1 upon ac times h upon k das dx times t minus t infinity is equal to zero. Let's assume that this equation is double star equation. Okay. So we can consider two different type of pin. One of them has as you see the one of them is different cross-section area, the other one is another
Hocam blade and
cross-section area.
wrought iron.
Okay. The right-hand side has both are right-hand side is known as pin fin, but the other one is has different cross-section area as you see. Okay, and perimeter for left case is equal to 2 times width plus 2 times thickness. Okay, T shows thickness and omega shows width of the pin fin. And right-hand side perimeter is equal to PD. Okay, because cross-section area is circular. And then cross-section surface of the left case is width times thickness, and for left-hand side case cross-section area is equal to PD square upon 4, as you know. Now we assume that cross-section area does not change in x direction. Then the AC dx equals to zero. And also if we consider surface area is equal to px. If we differentiate both sides, das is equal to pdx. Then double star equation is reduced to d square t dx square minus h times perimeter upon k times ac times t minus t infinity is equal to zero. Okay, so as you see, this is a second order linear differential equation in temperature. Okay, so if we assume that t minus t infinity is equal to theta to simplification, then equation becomes d square theta dx square minus m square theta is equal to zero. So this m square is also a constant because we assume that h constant, perimetric constant, k constant, and cross-section area constant. Then m square is constant. Then we can evaluate characteristic equation from differential equation, and then we can solve easily, as you remember from license knowledge. Now let's look boundary conditions. So we have different boundary conditions at x is equal to zero. T is equal to temperature is equal to temperature at base. Okay, base is the dead region. Okay, T base for both case. And also at x is equal to L, at the fin tip. Okay, at the fin tip we have cases. So case 1 TL is equal to T infinity for sufficiently large length. Okay. For example, we can consider L goes to infinity for this case. Okay. So the second case at the fintip, we assume that fintip is insulated. Then temperature gradient in x direction is equal to zero at x is equal to L. So we can assume that this case, as you see from figure, a pin fin again, but has length of 2L. Okay. So at the midpoint, we have symmetry condition. Both cases are identical. Okay. For x is equal to L insulated. And also for 2L at the midpoint, symmetry boundary condition are identical. And third case, at the tip, conduction heat rate is equal to convection heat rate, okay, minus Ka dT dx at x is equal to L is equal to h times A times TL minus T infinity. So this one is convection rate, okay. So let me add fourth case to write. Okay. So for this case, case four, convection and radiation. Both okay with each other. Convection plus radiation. So we can consider combined heat radiation. Sorry, combined heat transfer coefficient HC. As you remember, okay. So this one is subscript should be, but I don't know what can I write. Okay, HC combined heat transfer coefficient. So this case is your homework. You solve this case, okay? So let's look first three case put together, but this fourth case is your homework. Okay, let's continue. This one is. Okay, there is no problem. So let's look first case. Solution of the differential equation gives theta is equal to C1 times E2 minus MX plus C2 times E2 plus MX. Because solution of this differential equation, as you remember, gives characteristic equation is equal to r square minus m square is equal to zero, then r is equal to plus minus m, and then that gives characteristic equation as c1 plus e2 minus mx plus c2 times e2 plus mx, as you remember. Okay. And then we can apply boundary conditions. So theta is equal to theta subscript b is equal to t base minus t infinity at x is equal to zero at the base. Okay. Then theta base is equal to c1 plus c2. And also theta is equal to zero because t goes to temperature at the fintip goes to t infinity because x is equal to L when L goes to infinity. Therefore, from this case, we found C2 is equal to zero. Then temperature difference or theta is equal to theta base times e to minus m x. So heat transfer rate at the base Q base is equal to minus k times cross section area times d theta dx at x is equal to zero. So let's substitute theta into the equation. It becomes minus k times cross section area times minus m theta base times e to minus m x at x is equal to zero. So it is written as k times cross section area times m times theta base. Or we substitute m into the equation. It is written as q at the base is equal to square root of h times perimeter times k times ac times sorry ac times theta at base. Okay. Or we can evaluate heat transfer rate at the base integrating convection. So integral from 0 to infinity h times p times t minus t infinity dx is equal to integral from 0 to infinity h times p times theta dx. So that is equal to h times p times theta b times integral from 0 to infinity e to minus mx dx. Let me clear this. Okay. And then continuing, taking integral, then that gives h times perimeter times theta at base times 1 of minus 1 upon m e to minus m x from 0 to infinity. So that gives same result from previous evaluation, considering with previous evaluation. Okay. So let's assume that Q B zero, B heat transfer without fin at the base. For this case, we assume that there is no fin. Heat is transferred at the base cross section area. So Q for both case with fin and without fin cross section area are same. Then heat transfer rate at the base without fin is written as h times cross section area times TB minus T infinity. TB is base temperature. And this is written as H times AC times theta at base. So we can consider fin effectiveness. Fin effectiveness is written as the ratio of heat transfer rate for both case. As you see, numerator involves heat transfer rate with fin, and denominator involves heat transfer rate without fin. This ratio gives fin effectiveness. This is equal to square root of perimeter times K upon H times AC. So fin efficiency is written as the ratio of actual heat transfer to heat which would be transferred if entire fin surface were at T base. So as you see from figure, we consider heat is transferred through the fin. For example, if temperature of the base at 100 degrees Celsius, for example, through the fin, temperature reduces. Okay, at the fin tip, reaches minimum value, as you see at the midpoint, for example, of the fin at 70 degrees Celsius, but at the fin tip, reaches or reduces to 40 degrees Celsius. In this case, we assume that environment at 20 degrees Celsius. So this is physically true. But the figure at the bottom figure, as you see, fin base is 100 degrees Celsius, fin tip 100 degrees Celsius, and also through the fin temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. It is physically is not true. It is impossible. Okay, if fin length goes to infinity, we can assume that fin tip reaches at the T infinity. But the second case, as you see from the second figure, is not true. Okay, let's back to efficiency, fin efficiency. Fin efficiency is written as Q F upon Q max. Okay, and then is if we substitute Q max into the equation, it becomes Q F upon H times A F theta B, where A F is total surface area of the fin. So then if we substitute QF, fin efficiency becomes in square root H times perimeter times K times AC times theta B upon H times, in order to AF, we use P perimeter times length times theta B. So that is equal to 1 upon M times L. Okay. So this is a result of the first case. Let's consider with a second case. At the fin tip, we have insulation. That means, as you remember, there is no temperature gradient at the fin tip. So boundary conditions, temperature is equal to base temperature at x is equal to zero, and temperature gradient is equal to zero at fin tip. So theta upon theta base is equal to hyperbolic cosine m times l minus x, divided by hyperbol cosine m times l. Okay. And Q heat transfer rate at the base is equal to in square root h times perimeter times k times cross section area times theta base times tangent hyperbolic tangent ml. So ratio or heat fin efficiency is equal to square root of perimeter times k upon h times cross section area times tangent hyperbolic tangent ml. So if we look at hyperbolic tangent curve, as you see from figure, maximum value reads 1, as you see, okay, when x goes to infinity. So as m times l goes to infinity, hyperbolic tangent ml goes to 1. And for under this condition, we reach same result as previous case. Okay, if h if x goes to infinity. So let's look the terms m l square of m l. Let's rewrite this term as h times perimeter upon k cross section area times l square. If we rewrite both numerator and denominator as l upon k times ac and also 1 upon h times perimeter times l respectively. So numerator shows internal thermal resistance in x direction. And also denominator shows external resistance, thermal resistance also. Okay. So that means the terms square of ML is hybrid Biot number. Okay. And also again we can write both numerator and denominator as h times perimeter times l upon k times ac upon l, as you see. So that means numerator shows external convection and denominator shows internal conduction. So this ratio gives square of m l. If ML is large enough, internal resistance is large. That's TL is very close to T infinity. Let's look the numerical values. If hyperbolic tangent or ML is greater than 3, as you see, hyperbolic tangent 3 gives 0.99505, so it's close to 1, as you see. And if ML is greater than 3, we evaluate k is 1, infinite fin approximation. Okay, because tangent ML goes to 1. Okay. Let's look an example. Consider a stainless steel pin fin. As you see from figure, within the boiling water. So heat is transferred by convection. So consider a heat transfer rate, sorry, heat transfer coefficient is 5000, conduction is 16, length of the fin is 0.1 and diameter is 0.01. So let's evaluate the ratio perimeter to area. Is found as 4 upon d, and we can evaluate m times l as 35.36 is much greater than 1. And then if we look at fin efficiency, q sub 0 upon q sub b 0 approximately equal to square root of perimeter times case upon h times a c. That gives 1.13 as you see. So because ml is greater than, much greater than 1, then hyperbolic tangent ml goes to 1. So this case reduces to infinite length case. Okay, that means fin effectiveness only 13% improvement gives 30% improvement. Okay, because in this case heat transfer coefficient is much greater than conductivity. Therefore, heat is transferred mainly by convection. Okay. Let's assume that H is equal to 10 for same problem. Okay. That means air free convection or we consider this case as free convection case. There is no forced convection because heat transfer coefficient is so less. Okay, and then if we look at ML, we see that ML is equal to 1.581, and then fin efficiency approximately equal to 23.2. As you see, fin effectiveness is higher than the first case. That means heat is transferred by conduction mainly. Okay? Or convection heat transfer rate is less than conduction heat transfer rate. Okay. So you can look several examples about this subject from heat transfer books.
Pardon hocam, this ML value, where we get this value 1.581?
Repeat, please.
Pardon hocam, I'm very sorry. This ML value equal to 1.581. How
Okay.
we calculate this value hocam, or where we get this one?
Okay. Considering by new value of heat transfer, H is equal to 10 for the second case. Okay.
Tamam hocam.
First case, heat transfer coefficient is 5000. Is so much, as you know. We can consider this case is forced convection. But in second case, we consider free convection case. Heat transfer is less, so less is equal to 10. The other parameters are same. Okay, does not change. Therefore, we evaluate ML for considering H is equal to 10. Then that gives ML is equal to 1.5. Comparing with previous case, is so less. Therefore, hyperbolic tangent ML does not reach one or is not close to one as first case. Okay. Therefore, inefficiency change. Okay.
Hocam.
Tamam hocam.
Hocam.
Okay.
Hello hocam. Hello
So
hocam.
I hear.
Ya
Let's
hocam
see.
about as Muhammed asking you ML calculated from equations or from chart we have this value.
You
This
can
is for
evaluate by using both
both
calculation or chart.
chart. Okay.
It is not important, but as you know, if you use chart,
Any
that is
chart.
more error, read error, as you know. Therefore, calculation gives better result. Okay, more precise.
From an expression hocam calculation from an expression.
Okay. Okay, let's have a break and then we will continue. Okay. Okay, let's continue with rectangular fin of maximum heat per given weight case. Okay. Now we can consider a rectangular cross-section area pin, as you see from figure. Width of the fin is fixed. And weight, as you know, rho times peripheral area times width, where AP is equal to L times T. So, changing length and thickness so as to give maximum heat transfer rate at base for given peripheral area. So, as you see, peripheral area is lateral surface and cross-section area is fin cross-section area is also fin tip area. Okay. Omega times T. So again we can consider correct length. L goes to corrected length, as you know. So, sorry, spotlight. Okay. So let's write Q base as evaluated before. Heat transfer rate at base is equal to square root of H times perimeter times K times cross section area times theta. It's base times hyperbolic tangent M L. So if we assume that width is much greater than thickness, okay. Evaluate M.
Çocuklar için mi bu?
At first evaluate M is equal to square root of H times perimeter upon K times cross section area. So this approximately equals to square root of H times V reduce P term by considering, as said before, width of the fin is much greater than thickness. We assume that perimeter is equal to 2 times width, okay? Because thickness is so less. And divided by k times cross-section area is omega times t. So that gives square root of 2h upon kt. Now, let's come back to Q base. Let's substitute cross section area and perimeter into the equation. Then square root of h times 2 omega times k times omega t times the base times tangent, hyperbolic tangent, m is evaluated before. Square root of 2h upon kt times n. Okay. Then that gives the transfer rate at base is equal to omega times square root of 2 times h times k times t times theta base hyperbolic tangent square root of 2h upon kt times AP upon thickness. As I said before, AP is equal to L times thickness. Okay. So, to maximize heat transfer rate at base, we equate dQ dt to zero, okay? Under this condition, Q base becomes maximum. Then let's differentiate heat transfer rate we previously evaluate, and let's differentiate with respect to time. So as you see, we have two time-dependent terms, thickness-dependent terms, sorry, as you see. Therefore, differentiation gives two different terms, comes from differentiation of multiplication. Let's differentiate first thickness-dependent term and multiply by the second one, as you know. So that gives 1 upon 2 times square root of t times hyperbolic tangent square root of 2h upon kt ap upon thickness, and minus comes from thickness value, okay, because thickness is in denominator, as you see, for second term, and then minus square root of thickness times square root of 2h upon k times ap times 3 upon 2 times t to minus 5 upon 2 times 1 upon hyperbolic cosine square square root of 2h upon kt ap upon thickness is equal to zero. So to write this expression, we apply some simplifications, okay? And then remember that differentiation of hyperbolic tangent gives 1 upon hyperbolic cosine square x, okay? So let's assume that u is equal to, or u is identical, square root of 2h upon kt times ap upon thickness. if we substitute into the equation, that gives hyperbolic tangent u is equal to 3 times u upon hyperbolic cosine square u. So so this expression, both expression are same. Okay, if you apply, you evaluate this simpler expression by using previous expression. Okay, both are same, both are identical. By considering u, or assuming that u, we evaluate simpler expression than previous one. Okay. So if we evaluate u, then we can evaluate optimum thickness or optimum length, okay, or both. So to evaluate u, as you see from this expression, you need a numerical solution. So another homework for you, evaluate u term by using any numerical root finding method. For example, it can be Newton-Raphson fixed point, and also false position, and etc. One of them, you find value of u. Okay, you can write a simple MATLAB code to find u. This in this code you can apply root finding method, any of them, as said before. Okay, this is second homework. find value of u numerically. By writing a script, MATLAB script. okay. So it is a simple code and short script, okay? It is not it is easy, it is. So by using numerical method, you evaluate u as 1.419. Your code evaluate more precise value, okay, than this one. So right hand side is equal to 2h upon k t l, as you see this term, okay, u is equal to this term. And then if we apply mathematical manipulation, then we can rewrite this expression as 1.419 times square root of kt upon 2h is equal to l. Again, continuing mathematical manipulation, we evaluate left hand side 1.419 times square root of 2k upon ht is equal to length upon thickness upon 2. So if we look at the term in square root. So this term is written as 1 upon Biot number. And then for this case, we assume that Biot number is equal to h times t upon 2 upon k. Okay? Okay. So let's look an example. We need to evaluate optimum length and optimum thickness under this condition. Heat transfer coefficient H is equal to 5 and conductivity is 200 and thickness is given as 0.002 meter and length is given as 0.05. Okay. To maximize heat transfer rate, we try to evaluate optimum length and optimum thickness. So peripheral area is equal to T times L. Then peripheral area is equal to 10 to minus it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10 to minus 5. 10 to minus 5. 10 to minus 4. Okay. 10 times 10 to minus 5. Okay. 10 to minus 4. So let's find optimum thickness and optimum length. So by using this expression, we substitute values of thickness H and K into the expression. Then we evaluate optimum thickness as 0.628 millimeter, as you see. Okay. And peripheral area does not change. Therefore, is constant. Then we can find optimum length with respect to thickness as 0.159 meter or approximately 15.9 centimeter. Okay. Depending on heat convection, okay, coefficient H. If heat convection coefficient change, for example, in this case is I think 20. Okay. Thickness by similar manner is found as 0.998 approximately 1 millimeter. Then optimum length becomes 0.1 meter or 10 centimeter. Okay. So that shows if thickness increase, then length decreases. Okay. If thickness decreases for the first case, length increases. So there is a trade-off between thickness and length. Okay, to evaluate optimum value of thickness and length of the fin. Okay, this is second. Okay, don't forget this homework because I want to clear. Okay, let's continue. Okay, for this case, let's consider a variable fin thickness. for this case. Straight fin of the triangle profile. Okay. Let's rewrite heat equation for variable thickness of the fin. So d square t dx square plus 1 upon ac times dac dx times dt dx minus 1 upon ac times h upon k dAs dx times t minus t infinity is equal to 0. So in first case, we assume that cross-section area does not change. But in this case, cross-section area changes in x direction, as you see. So cross-section area depends on x is equal to thickness times width times x upon L. So surface area, considering surface area, DAS is written as perimeter times DX times cosine alpha. Remember that tangent alpha is equal to thickness upon 2 upon L from geometry of the fin. Okay. Again, we assume that width of the fin is much greater than thickness. Then perimeter is assumed approximately equal to 2 times width. Okay. Under this condition, if width much larger than thickness, then cosine alpha goes to 1. Okay. Then dAs dx is equal to 2 times width. So again, assuming the difference t minus infinity as theta, let's rewrite heat equation as by using theta d square theta dx square plus 1 upon x times we substitute cross-section area and surface area, related surface area, into the heat equation. Then we evaluate 1 upon x times L upon t omega times t omega upon L t theta dx minus L upon x times t times omega times h upon k times 2 omega theta is equal to 0. So after simplifications, it is reduced to d square theta dx square plus 1 upon x times d theta dx minus beta times theta upon x is equal to 0. This equation is modified Bessel equation. Remember, a modified Bessel equation, where beta is equal to 2 times h times L upon k times t. So the solution of this differential equation gives theta is equal to a times zeroth order modified Bessel equation. I zero of 2 times square root of beta x plus b times I zero is first kind and k zero is second kind, as you know, as you remember. K zero of 2 times square root of beta x. Okay. So let's evaluate this solution. Okay. Drive the solution between from this point to this point. Okay. Because we previously evaluate the solution of Bessel equations, okay? And then you can easily evaluate this solution. This is another homework. Let's continue. So again, considering Bessel equation, d squared is the dx squared plus, okay, the solution is here. And there is no homework for this. Okay, I will give. So let's u is equal to 2 times square root of eta x. Sorry. So x is equal to is written as u square of u square upon 4 times beta. And if we differentiate u with respect to x, we evaluate du dx is equal to square root of beta upon x is equal to 2 beta time upon u. Now evaluate d theta dx and d squared theta dx squared in terms of d theta du and d squared theta d squared du respectively. Okay, let's evaluate d theta dx at first by using chain rule. Is written as d theta du du dx. And as you know, as after simplification, both sides are same. And we know u if and also we know differentiation of u with respect to x. Now we can evaluate d theta dx as square root of beta upon x times d theta du, as you see. So to evaluate second order differential term d theta d squared theta dx squared in terms of d theta du and d squared theta du squared, let's differentiate previous result d dx of d theta dx, or we substitute d theta dx as square root of beta upon x d theta du. As you see, we need to differentiate a term in multiplication as in multiplication. Then we evaluate minus 1 upon 2 square root of beta times 1 upon x times square root of x d theta du plus square root of beta upon x d squared theta du square. Again, we use chain rule du dx. And we substitute du dx into the equation. Then we evaluate d squared theta dx squared is equal to minus square root of beta upon 2x times square root of x d theta du plus beta upon x d squared theta du squared. Now, star equation, original modified Bessel equation becomes, as you see, I don't want to repeat, okay? And then after simplification, we evaluate d squared theta d squared plus 1 upon u d theta du minus theta is equal to 0. So remember modified Bessel equation, as you see. So this one is modified Bessel equation of zeroth order, okay? And then general solution There is no solution. Okay. Your previous homework is valid. Okay. There is no solution. Okay. You try to solve because we evaluate modified Bessel equation by using another assumption. U is equal to 2 times square root of beta x. But there is no solution here. Okay. So general solution is evaluated before a times I sub 0 of u plus b times k sub 0 of u. And we can substitute value of u as 2 times square root of beta x into equation we previously evaluate. Same result. Okay. But solution of this differential equation is not here. This one is your homework. Okay. Homework is valid. The last homework is valid. So we can we continue with boundary conditions for this case, but not this time. Okay. These are enough for this week. We will continue next week. Don't forget your homework. Is there any question?
Sir, how is your health? I was guess you are still in sick health.
Okay, it's better than previous, but I try to gain okay my health. Sorry for my health care.
İnşallah hocam you will recover soon.
Okay, thanks. Your kindness. Okay. Okay. See you next week. We will continue. Okay. Good week. Good weekend. Everybody.
Thank you hocam. Fi imanillah. Allah
Both
emanet.
you. Both you. Thanks. Okay.